Here we define now data structure. A data structure is a data organization, management and storage format for an efficient access and modification. More precisely, a data structure is a collection of data values, the relationships among them, and the functions or operations that can be applied to the data. And by functions operations, we mean also their semantics, means their behavior that these functions and operations will do modified in terms of the data values on top of the data structure. So a data structure shows the developer. By developer here, we mean the programmer that implements this data structure, while the absolute data type shows the user's perspective, which is in that sense also a programmer, but it's the programmer that uses this implemented data structure and absolute data type. Okay? And the data structure comes with supported operations. Let's have a look at some basic data structures about the array, which we know already, and the list. In both cases, they represent an ordered set of elements. Typical operations that you can do is that you can insert at front, you can insert somewhere, which means random position or the end. You can replace something at the front, at the end, or in random location. You can remove or retrieve something. You want to index an element, it means you want to retrieve an element, like the fifth element, or you want to walk over all elements, which is iteration. So in our array, we store it as a contiguous memory region, which we know about, and the list now stores the same data, but using pointers. So the idea is we have basically those elements stored, but those elements can be stored somewhere in main memory. And how we find out where the next element is? Well, we have to use a pointer from the first element to the second element and from the second element to the third. So how does a list implementation look like? In a very basic form, a list element is a void pointer, which is the element itself and its data, and the pointer to the next element. Okay, and if there's no next element, so we reach the end of the list, we could say it's null. Now we could say that we define it, our data type is list LMT type, and when we initialize a list, all we need to create is we create an empty element as a head element. Therefore we use malloc, of course, to initialize this data structure, create this data structure, and memset to initialize it with zero. And then you would have this list head as a first element, and then you have basically pointers to the elements and the pointer to the next element in this list, where the last element has should be a null pointer. So how does this now work to add a new element? Well, let's assume we have two elements. We have basically at memory location 4712 this head, and then we have another element at location 5000, and then this is the last one, so it has a null pointer here. The list push function, what it needs to do, it needs to add as a new third element, and the third element should be this one here. Okay, we create a new element at position 10,000. We have to fill in this user data, which is the void pointer. And then we have to change the pointers now. So basically, in this case, what we do, we take the list head, which is our previous head, and what we do, we let it point to this newly created element here. Okay, so these three lines create this new element and set the values. So we set LLM to be this user specified element, and we set, now what we do is we set the next pointer in this newly created element to be the previous next element of the list. So basically we remove this link over here, yeah, and now make this new element point to our previous element, and then we make the head point to our new element. Okay, so that's what you find here. So the head now points to the new element points to wherever the head has pointed before. So this allows us to append something in the list head, basically, And when we want to remove something, what we need to do? Well, here we have our example. From the list head, we can take the element it points to and have to remove it. Yeah, but if the list has no next element, so if it's only the list head, then we cannot remove an element, so we return null. Otherwise, what we'll do is we change the pointers. All we need to do is we have to figure out our list element, this one, the first element that we will remove. Where does it point to? So it points to this element. And now we have to change the pointer of our list head and make it point to this element. Okay, so that's the result. And that's what happens here. So if you find this a bit confusing and a bit quick, please go over it slowly and try to reproduce, you know, those code examples here and here. And I'm sure you will understand how this works and how from the situation before you will end in the situation after executing those commands. Note, interestingly, what we did, when we push something, we push it always as being the newest element is basically on the front. And when we pop, we remove it. So basically, we did here now a last in, first out implementation, which is kind of a stack implementation of this list. Okay, the first element, the last element we pushed in was always this element here. So it's the first one that head points to. So when we pop it, we get this element out and not the end element of the list. So now how can we use this list in terms of being a user now? So an ADT user. Well, we can use this list for what we implemented as a stack, and it's quite the same as our array. So we can create this list, then we push on this list, this is a test, and then we can remove the first element, which is the last element here, the test basically, by using this pop function. If you want to iterate over the list, we will use typically the for loop, which is quite interesting, but instead of counting over a number of elements, what we do, we will initialize a new pointer from this next pointer of the head. And as long as our current element is not null, we can output the current element. And then we basically have to set the current element to be the next pointer. So that means we start from here, follow this pointer, and as long as this pointer doesn't point to null, we will print out this element, and then we follow the pointer again. So this pointer will be followed to the next element, and so on. That is a convenient way of traversing a list, and I find it also very elegant. So have a look and try to understand how this works.